Sub-Saharan Africa has been identified as the riskiest region in the world for business and investors. Now, this is owing to militant violence and abuses by security forces. According to experts, Africa needs foreign direct investment that can be pumped into manufacturing, investment that can be pumped into infrastructural development, and pretty much more. Now, for investors to come to Africa and invest money, they need to be assured that their investment is going to be safe. Now, for more on this, financial analyst Samson joins me now on the news. Good to have you join me. Well, looking at what's been happening on the continent, perhaps looking at crisis in pockets of areas, the Horn of Africa and a few other places, how does this affect the continent when it comes to investors looking outside the continent?
All right. Good afternoon, Suleiman Alede. Nice to have you on board. Yes, I think the FDI, to me, I feel that the African continent is a zone for every investor to think of investing. All right. Now, one thing that we should have at the back of our mind is, why are these investors willing to invest in Africa? Now, Africa has a vibrant potential in our GDP growth rate, which is an attractive indices that most of these developed countries are looking for. Now, we all know that there is this, how will I put it, there's this potential that we have in our GDP to grow, all right? And now for an investor looking for an investment destination, Africa as a continent is already ripe for them to invest. We are yet to get to the point where we have already maximized our output. So as we're getting more investment coming into Africa, we are going to achieve that growth rate. Now for the West, they are at the stage whereby capital injection will not give them the desired growth in their output because they need to put in technology and research. I think currently in quarter one in 2020, before the COVID-19 lockdown in most of the states, we are aware that the Silicon Valley guys invested over about $70 billion on R&D. All right, so that is what will drive their own economy GDP to grow. But in Africa, their capital investment is needed for us to now maximize our output. All right, yeah, thank you.
So now you mentioned the FDIs, which you say, well, is pretty much better than having grants. But looking at the continent for many years, some countries on the continent have relied on, you know, grants. How does this work, you know, getting to change the perspective, you know, the perception of the of countries on the continent when it comes to investors coming in?
I don't consider grant as an investment. Okay, yeah, because grant is just like maybe somebody needs something and you just, okay, let me just come and solve the hunger or to provide shelter for you. Now, what will impact on our economy is the direct investment. Let's say, for example, now we want to see like a McDonald's now set up a, maybe like a franchise or their own investment in Africa, training the African leaders in the food industry on the global best practice on how to run a restaurant chain business. Now we can see that the likes of ShopRite is an FDI, okay, coming into Africa, but all these investments, like coming to Africa to come and invest, it's more beneficial to our global economy than giving us grants, okay? Now the investment you have, and you're going to increase the output that each laborers are going to be creating in the Africa economy. We have some employment gap, okay, which by the time they set up their factory, their subsidiaries, or they just take up maybe direct investment in Africa, we are going to create more jobs for the teeming youth population that we have. And I can tell you, Africa has one of the, I know people will say China has a low cost of labor, okay, but I tell you, African countries, we have some countries that can offer lower and cheaper labor than other West countries. Yeah, the likes of Apple, I think they have an FDI in China. Okay, yeah, they have an FDI in China where they produce their other part of their goods as well. So if they come to Africa, we will resources in terms of human and teaming youth. Now, if you check the global industry indices on the teeming population in the world, Africa still has a young population who are willing to work. Now, the labor participation rate in Africa is very, very low, and this youth needs to be engaged. And it's the FDI invest in Africa that will get these youth to be engaged, and they will have some, maybe then the issue of insecurity, idleness, that you don't have anything to do, they are not properly engaged, will reduce drastically, having something to fold their hands on.
Now, let's see if we can close on this. Talking about Africa's, the strength of Africa's very young. And we have seen what COVID-19 has actually done, ravaging the world, which is, well, the downside is that it has actually affected a lot of businesses. What kind of business do you see coming into the continent in the foreseeable future, now that we're looking at investors coming, more investors coming into the continent?
Well, to me, I will go for agricultural. I think they should come and invest in the agricultural sector. Now, we all know that the project, most of the African African as a continent, most of the countries are still not using technology in our processes in farming, okay? Now, if an FDI will come in maybe to set up a model facility on farming, we have the land, our soil is well fertile to produce most of the crops. Like now, I was doing a research a couple of months ago with somebody from Lynx that said that we have a lot of viable land where we can farm rice. All right. So now the issue now is that we need 6 million metric ton of rice that's being consumed in Nigeria currently. Now we can only produce 3 million metric ton. That means the border needs to be open for us not to starve. Okay, I'm talking about Nigeria in particular. Now, in cut across the other countries in Africa, we have the land, okay, and then we have the resources in abundance. Now, what we now need is, if they can come into Soki, they are going to partner in creating technology on how we can maximize. I can tell you, Africa will feed the nation when it comes to food, yeah.
Well, thank you.
So I think agricultural sector is a good area for the direct investment to come in agri sector.
Well, that's a fine place for us to leave it there. Many thanks for spending time with us.